Hi everyone, and welcome back to another unboxing from the past. So today we are going to unbox this pair of Nikes from the 80s. Just kidding, of course. If you've already seen the title and the thumbnail of the video, you will know what I am unboxing today. It's a real special accessory for the Sony Discmans from the 80s, especially the first, I would say the first and second generations. So I've been excited about this all week. I finally received it yesterday, and without further ado, let's just get into it. So there is a little note from the seller, always nice. And after that, I have some packaging and the star of the show. So we're just gonna put this to the side for 1 second. So we also have a some kind of belt, a carrying belt, something like that. And finally we have a Discman. This is one of the heaviest Discmans that I have. You can just feel it just from the first time you pick it up. And let's see which model this is. So this carrying case, this Sony Discman carrying case, is quite nice. Sadly, on the edges they've put the same type of material that the mini disc carrying cases are made of, which you can see is crumbling away and falling apart. So that's some nasty stuff. Anyway, let's just get the Discman out of its carrying case and let's put that to the side. Fully metal body. So which model is this? Oh, there it is. This is the Sony D4. So this is one of the earliest models of Discmans that came out. And it also has a battery, I believe. Yeah, and it is quite a long battery. So this is a 1000 milliamps, which kind of it, it must be a metal hydride, because I don't think lithium ion batteries existed back in those days. Or maybe they did, but they are not like commonplace like they are nowadays. So there it is. So I haven't tried this Discman yet. It didn't come with a charger, but thankfully, so it has the 9-volt center negative, which I have plenty of those chargers around. And let me just put this battery back in place and we're gonna try and test it. But before we do that, let's get to the real unboxing. So as you can see, this is a very special accessory for the Sony Discmans, especially the ones from the 80s, because they do not all take this accessory. The only ones that accept this accessory is the ones with this headphone jack that's labeled remote. I imagine there are also wired remotes which you can use, you know, in conjunction with your Discman in your setup. So as you can see, this is still in box. Of course, the box is not in the best of shapes, as always. But thankfully, someone took care of this box for so many years, for more than 30 years I'd say. The RM DM1K wireless remote control kit, equipped with remote control jack for Discman. So this is a very rare accessory, and they go for quite the hefty price nowadays, because there aren't so many out there, sadly, especially in box like this. This is actually the second time I've come across this accessory in box, just like this one. Thankfully this time I was able to buy it. I was like the first to bid or to just buy it. So there you have it, everything that's in the box. So we have the operating instructions, the instructions manual, the very famed RM DM1K. Of course there are several models with different models. I think there's also the DM5K, as you can see that's the IR receiver, the headphone jack to put it into the Discman, of course. And yeah, so quite the neat device. And of course the remote that goes with it. As you can see, Discman on the bottom. And the number for the model number for the remote is the RM DM1. And I suspect there are also the RM DM5 or something like that. So apparently you can control tuner and CD with this. I don't have any Sony tuner, so I don't really know. So there you have it. Apparently, maybe I suspect this was never used, maybe apart from getting it out of the box, maybe trying it and putting it back in the box way back in the day. And lastly, let's take a look at the instructions manual. As you can see, this was out in 86, printed in Japan. Of course, the instructions are quite simple. Just plug and play, you plug it into the device, and the rest of the functions are quite self-explanatory. This is most of the things that we still use nowadays with all of our media digital players, and the rest is quite, you know, self-explanatory. So if you want to take a look at the instructions, you are welcome to. You can just pause the video. Okay, let's give the Discman a try and let's see if it's operational or not. I suspect not, but let's just see. Let's try some monkey business. So sadly, this one does not show any signs of life. That's gonna be a future repair video. So we're gonna test it with this Discman D88. And just one thing to note is that this particular Discman was not made to be used alongside this accessory, even though you can use it. But as you will see, when you put the accessory in place like this, you are basically covering up the volume wheel. As you can see, you can no longer access the volume control. And of course, as you know, there is not a digital volume control on the remote control itself, nor on the Discman. So this would have been useful with this model in particular if it had a line out. So I mean, this would not have been a much of a problem if this particular Discman had a line out port, but sadly it does not. Just for the purposes of testing it, where I'm gonna leave it this way, that way I'm gonna have access to the volume wheel. So let's just put it very delicately on the table and let's try it. I'm gonna put the headphones in. So let's try to start it with the remote itself. As you can see, you do not need to necessarily be in the direct line of sight from the receiver. IR of course is a is light electromagnetic waves which can be reflected, so I suspect it's gonna work even like this. So there you go. I love this album. It's a classic. Turn it back around, and of course if you want to use it necessarily with this device, once you set the volume you can leave it like this, which in my opinion looks hella cool. That was it, everyone. I hope you enjoyed. There's gonna be a repair video for this original Discman that this unit came with. And the one thing I also noticed about this unit is that the remote control, the remote headphone jack has this little plastic nipple, you would call it, which sticks out a little bit, and that's actually because it was made for this particular accessory in mind, with consideration for this accessory, which has a the correspondent hole. So when you put it on this device, it's gonna sit, and it's gonna sit quite perfectly, let us say. That way it's not gonna it's not gonna move. So there you have it, folks. I hope you enjoyed, and hope you liked this unboxing video of this relic from the past. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like. If you are not already, you can subscribe. Until next time, this was the Electron Age. Bye.